Good news, everyone! Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. Or wait, no, that's not quite right either. Well, not, I guess it is sort of right, because I will be walking you through what you can do here with the mass annotation downloader thing that got you your annotations, assuming that you got them within the time span that this thing was able to pull it off in, because the annotations were gone within a few hours after the deadline came, and yeah, so, you know, you got your annotations. They are in the big fat folder of stuff. Well, it's not that big or anything like that. But yeah, you got a bunch of stuff there, but, you know, the way that you had to convert them before was kind of annoying, because you had links and stuff like that that you had to go through, and yeah, it's a lot of code to sift through, but there's a bit of an easier way to do that now, and I'll show you here. So you remember the YouTube annotation converter that I showed you here before by Eric Kaiser, also known as Mabam? Well, posted back here, and it's got a tool. Use that link, I'll put it in the description. And what you get is this zip folder, extract all, voila, there we go. And now what you do is, I'll just take, I guess, the Audacity tutorial. Wait, no, I don't have it open yet, I'm dumb. So what you do is, you can read how to use it, you just drag and drop stuff onto the converter, little dossy doss thingajigger will pop up eventually. Come on, hold on, it's safe, I know it's safe. Okay, there we go. Dang you, Windows. Dang you. Okay, so what it does is it pops us up. What? No, that's not. That's. What? Let's try that again. Well, it worked on the desktop. I don't know why it's not working here. Well, anyway, all you're supposed to do is just drag and drop it onto here, and I guess the laptop doesn't have VC runtime 140.dll. But that's okay. Well, what it's supposed to do is it's supposed to convert them into those SRT subtitles. You remember those subtitle files that we got from this, right? Right? Well, I'm going to show you how to use those suckers over here. And we go over to this dealio here. Oh, and you can also use them in, remember that anno fetch, we can use this to get the channel full of annotations and stuff like that. If you want to enter in your subtitles manually, like, you remember I got that whole big old code file like that there, and I didn't really show how to get that back into the web form, did I? No, I did not. So what you would do is you would open it up, and you go file, save as. You can save it as whatever, but you just gotta put .html at the end of it and save it as such. And I can close this little tabby out there, and then you open it in a web browser, and there we go, there they are in their original form. So you can go through and, you know, do the stuff and stuff like that that I showed you before, and yeah, so you can more easily copy paste whatever is in said stuff and whatnot. So yeah, there you go, that's another alternative way of doing that. But anyway, I still haven't showed you how to actually enter in subtitles, and that's where this comes in here. You go to one of your videos that has annotations, or I should say had annotations, and that's what the SRT files come in for. Go to subtitles/cc, which is known as closed captions, of course. And come on. Add new subtitles or CC, choose your language. Oh, I didn't prepare the SRT files. Oh, poopers, hold on. Okay, now from here. upload a file, which they're just going to ask you to do a little browsing here. You sometimes have to wait a bit after it gets past this screen. There we go. You go subtitles file. You'd think it would be transcript, but no, it's actually subtitles file. Go to browse. You put the folder, you enter in the folder that you want to put your SRT files into. Choose the SRT file that corresponds to your video. Plop that in there. Upload that sucker. And wait. Yeah, so this is obviously the wrong one. But I'm just showing you this as an example. But basically, you enter them in like you did annotations in a way. So yeah, you see this, you can drag it around on there to reposition it, and it even changes that. You can change the duration of it, you can even change those numbers manually and stuff like that. You can edit this, you can add in your own one manually, yeah, and it'll appear at the point in the video that you entered it in at. Alternately is going through all of that code stuff that I showed you before and just pasting it in at the appropriate time points. Like I showed you before on this or the like, is that you go over to said annotation. Oh wait, this is the wrong one. Ah no. Okay, there we go. So you open up one of these things. You can do this manually if you don't want to use the SRT converter. And you can see the time that it starts in the video, the time that it ends in the video. You would enter that, you know, at using the subtitle thing. It's got, this doesn't have a link. The text inset annotation for this appears up over there. There's separations for each individual annotation. Like you see, the less than sign, then annotation ID, and then you get all this stuff. That's one annotation. Next annotation is at next annotation ID, etc., etc., for how many you've got in each video. But that's a lot more tedious than using the SRT maker thing. So I wouldn't necessarily recommend doing this per se. just saying. But anyway. Now, after you get all your annotations back into whichever videos had annotations, how do you make sure that these suckers are going to be viewable to people? Because most people don't have closed captions / subtitles on by default. Well, that's where... I should actually get rid of this stuff. So that's where you go back over to the video. See over here in the tags down below here. Come on, load them. There we go. See all these tags over here. What you do is don't stop YouTube, please. I'm gonna have to tame you. So what you do is you take this special tag here. YT:CC equals on. It's a little code tag, and what you do is you paste that into there, control V, and then you save the changes. And what that'll do is it will force closed captions to appear for people, if you have closed captions in the video, of course. But you know, I don't have anything in here, so no closed captions for you on this video. I can, however, show an example of it popping up. Ah, yes, Halloween Randomness 2. That had some annotations in it at one point. Now you'll see, if you go to that video, this has got the closed caption tag thingy in there. See how it came up there? Yep. And just go over to when I am fighting annotations. Go over yes. to there, and... wait a second. I swear it should be working. Like, why is nothing working for me right now? This worked for me before. But yeah, it should, in theory, bring up said closed captions when they should come up on said video. Maybe yes. I should just try and refresh the video or something like that. But yeah, you see how they came up on how I had this kind of do that sort of thing. Yeah, let's try that again, actually. Let's refresh the page and see if CCs are automatically selected. Yeah, there we go. Now it's working this time. That is very weird. So yeah, that's how you would enter your closed captions slash subtitles. And yes, I know that's not the intended method for subtitles and closed captions, but who really is using them for transcribing your entire video of speech? Not that many people. So I figured that would be a nice way for annotations. I should say a nice place for annotations, but maybe it doesn't show up all the time like I thought it did with that tag, but it's supposed to. At the very least, it is something, after all. And I also put the annotations in the video descriptions as well. And I did that for all the videos that had text and stuff like that and whatnot. Now, if you missed the deadline to get your annotations via this, you might still have a shot at being able to get them. See, there's this YouTube Annotations Archive channel submitter, and it was just like grabbing all sorts of videos, just scouring the website for all sorts of things. I don't know where and how you get them off of this place, though, but it apparently has an archive of them somewhere. Maybe you have to make an account by logging in or something like that. I haven't been able to figure it out or anything like that. I didn't even try making an account because I'm not really sure if that's even the solution. So yeah. There is another place too, this other GitHub thingy here, and it's got a whole bunch of channels. They keep adding more and more channels as they go. It's kind of being updated fairly infrequently at the moment, but I'm sure they'll get them all up eventually. As you can see, it's 8 and 12 days ago, so it's been a while since they have updated, and I know that there's more channels that there will be put on here, so even if you missed the deadline to get them with the Mass Annotation Downloader, maybe one of the scouring programs slash bots brought them into one of these two things. So don't lose hope, you might still be able to get your annotations. And with that, I think I've covered pretty much everything left over with the whole annotation saga of YouTube. Well, I should say the end of annotation saga. Alas, they are gone, but they are not forgotten. So I hope you enjoyed. I hope you were able to save your annotations, and hope this helps you re-implement them and whatnot too. And I will see you in the next video.